Hello friends, welcome to Global Tech Learn. In today's video we will learn what is the JSON data. We will try to understand the JSON concepts. Then we will discuss why this is so popular nowadays and how we can read the JSON data from different sources. And we will go through a couple of examples to understand the JSON data types. Then finally we will import the data in Power BI and will apply some transformation over JSON data. And we'll try to build a report on top of that. Now let's start with what is JSON. JSON stands for JavaScript Object Notation. It is a standard text-based format for representing structured data based on JavaScript object syntax. It is mostly used for transmitting data in web application or storing data in different platforms. In JSON, usually it has key value approach that makes it very easy to understand. Here under examples, we have two examples. In first example, you can see the name is the key and Ryan is the value. Similarly, next to this, the age. Age is the key and the 25 is the value for the age. Same for the car, where we have car is the key. And that key has value BMW. And if I club all these three keys along with their values and enclosed it within the curly brackets, that makes it the JSON structure. So here you can see it's a very simple and easy to understand the JSON data type. It is quite easy readable and very easy to understand, just a key and values. Now let's discuss the second example where we have array included within the JSON. Here you can see for name key we have value Michael, and for age key we have value 30, and for cars we have multiple values Ford, BMW and Fiat, and all these three values are enclosed within square brackets. This is called array in JSON syntaxes. So in JSON, it gives flexibility to capture multiple values against one key, and we can include these within arrays. These are the some very powerful features of the JSON that gives it advantage over the other languages. In this example, you can see all these three attributes, that is name, age and car, are enclosed within the curly brackets. So that makes it as an object, and under object we have three keys, three attributes, and under each attribute we have key, that is name, age and car, and for car we have three different values that are array. As you can see here, since there are so many tags to structure this data, there are hardly couple of tags like curly bracket, square bracket, comma, double quotes and few more. As these are limited tags, that makes the JSON as a lightweight and compact language. Since it is lightweight and compact structure, so it does not require so many huge space, bandwidth or resources to use the data. That's why it is mostly used while transmitting data over the web. Now let's see how to format this data in JSON. Now here in Notepad we have one example of the JSON data, where we have three keys, that is customer name, sold quantity and sales price. Now let's say we want to structure this data. For that, there are many online parsers available that we can use to parse this data to make it readable. Or the other way, there are so many extensions available. Say for example, for this Notepad++, there is a JSON extension available. So here you can see when I click on JSON Viewer, it has given me JSON Viewer pane on the left side, and there I can see it has given me the tree structure of the JSON data. So here we can see we have two objects. So as we discussed, the curly brackets makes it objects. So the first object starts from this curly bracket till this point. And then second object start from this point till the last curly bracket. Now under JSON Viewer we can see we have customer name, sold quantity sales price. Then we have customer name, sold quantity, sales price for second object. So this is a JSON viewer from where we can see the hierarchy or the structure of the data. Now let's see if we want to make the data readable on the right pane. In that case, we can use the same extension, and under JSON viewer we have format JSON option available. So let's click on this, and here you can see it has made it readable formats. So now from the first object, start from line number 2 till the line number 6, and then second object start from line number 7 till the line number 11. And as we can see, there are two objects, or we can say two instances. That's why these are enclosed within the square brackets. So these are the array of the two objects. Now let's try to see some of the JSON parsers available online. So let me select this text again, and let's go to the browser. And here we have JSON parser. There are so many JSON parsers available online, but let me select the first one and put this text here. And on the right side, you can see it has given us the past output that are the again the same two objects. As we can see, the JSON has really good syntax that makes it easy to read and understand the underlying data. And since it is widely used in IT industry, that's why in most of the languages like Python, Java, we will find the JSON related inbuilt functions in all these technologies. So far we learned what is JSON, its syntax is, why it is so popular, how to format it to make it readable, and what are the various JSON parsers available online as well as the extensions. With this, I hope now you have got the basic idea of the JSON. Now let's jump to JSON in the Power BI, where we will try to import JSON data files in the Power BI. We will try import two files in Power BI. The one is the simple JSON file, and the another where the data would be a bit complex. And then we will try to make some transformations over that complex data. After that, we will try to build report on top of that JSON data. Now let's discuss the first data file, that is customerdata.json. So here let me enable the JSON Explorer first. So on the left side we can see we have JSON viewer where we have root. Under root we have various objects. Let me expand the first object, and under first object we can see we have customer name attribute, then we have sold quantity and sales price. Similarly, for the next object, we have customer name, sold quantity, and sales price. So this is the simple JSON data that we can import in Power BI. So now let's jump into the Power BI and import this file. So in Power BI, to import the JSON data, we can simply click on the Get Data, Files. And under files, we can see the JSON data type is available. So let's click on connect and choose the file customerdata.json and click on open. Now here you can see, while reading data from the JSON, Power BI has applied couple of steps on this data. So this is the Power BI intelligence features available within the mQuery. Power BI has applied all those functions which are applicable to make it readable format to the end user. So let's go with the step by step. In first step, we can see Power BI has read each object as the record from the JSON. That is same object we can see here in JSON viewer. Let's go to the next step. There we can see Power BI has converted all these objects in a table. Then in the next step, it has tried to extend the columns, that means extract the key and the values from the objects that we can see here. We have customer name, sold quantity and sales price. Similarly, here in source file we can see in each object we have customer name, sold quantity and sales price. Same we can see in data as well. After that, Power BI has applied some data types to make it data in a correct data type. For example, here sold quantity we can see here it is converted to the numbers. Similarly, sales price has converted to the numbers. Now let's close and apply all these steps on the data and go to the report viewer. Now here in report viewer, let's try to create one visual on top of this data. So here we can see we have all these three fields available from JSON data. Let's select customer name. Let me make it matrix and then select sales price and sold quantity. And here we go, we have created one basic visual on the JSON data file. Now let's discuss the second example file that we have for today, that is quizdata.json. In this file you can see it start with curly brackets, so it is an object, and under object we have quiz, and for quiz we can see we have square brackets, that means it is an array. So under quiz we will have multiple objects, and under quiz we have again curly brackets, that means these are the objects, and under object we have question, and after question we have options, that option is again an array. So under options we will have multiple values, and then we have answer attribute. So from this data we can understand this is the quiz data where we have multiple questions, and under each question we will have multiple options, and for each question we will have answer. So if we try to summarize this file, we have JSON. Under JSON again we have JSON, and under JSON we have array data types. So this is called as a nested JSON, where within JSON objects we are getting again the different JSON structure data types. To handle this kind of JSON data files, we require some transformation in the Power BI to make it two-dimensional data to plot report on top of that data. So before jump into Power BI, let's try to see the same structure from the JSON viewer. So for that, let me refresh this. And on the left side, you can see in JSON viewer, first we have root, then under root we have quiz, that is type of array that we can see over here. Let me expand this, and under array we can see there are two objects. So this is our first object, then this is the second object, this is our second object. Now let me expand the object, and here we can see under object we have question, and next to question there is a options. Under options we have four different options, and then we have answer. So now let's go to the Power BI and let's try to import this data. So again we will go to get data from file and select JSON, and here we can select quiz data, open, now here in Power BI query editor we can see Power BI has applied some steps on this data. So let's go through this first. So the first step is Power BI tried to pull data as a list. Then from list it tried to convert it into the table. Then from table is try to expand the records. So there it found two records, that is quiz 1 and quiz 2. Okay, then it tried to split the columns from this data. So we can see it has question 1, question, and under that it has options and then answer. Okay, now let's move further and it tried to change the data type. So these are the same steps that were applied for the first file. Let me go there. So here we can see it's almost all the steps it applied for customer data, which is the simple JSON data file. The same steps Power BI has applied for second file, but since it is nested JSON, so it tried to split the column or some few more steps, but at the end we see the data is not in the readable format. So here we can see if we try to plot this data, this would be the bit complicated to present data because this is not the two-dimensional data. So we need to transform this data to make it vertically readable format that we can present on the visual. So now let's try to transform this data to make it vertical readable data that we can present on the report. For that, as we know from the JSON structure, that the option is the array that we can unpivot. So for that, let me select the option 0 to 3 and let's apply unpivot on this. And here we can see now we have question column, then we have answer, and then we have attribute and value. So let me rename these field names. So let's make it question. Then answer. Then these are the options. And then we have option values. Now this data looks okay that we can present on the visual to make it readable for the users. So let me close and apply the query editor. And let's come back to the Power BI report viewer. Let me add another page. And here let's try to create a new visual. That is table. Let me make it matrix, and under matrix we can select the question, and after question we can select the option values, and then we can select the answer. So let me drag the answer under the rows, and from here this makes user readable. When user expand from the question, that is in which country is the world most highest waterfall, then there under that we can see there are four options: Brazil, Finland, USA, Venezuela, and then we can get the answer under that is Venezuela. So this is all for today's session. If you have any query or if you need further details on the JSON data files with the Power BI, then put your questions in comments window and we will try to answer your questions. If you want the sample data files for your practice purpose, then you can get these files from our Telegram channel that you can find about. To learn more about the Power BI and SQL, stay tuned for the next video. Till then, take care.